Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today with a game that I haven't talked about in quite some time. This is Wildfire Worlds, currently in alpha, which means it's still in development by Dot Product, but they have released a paid alpha, which you can now buy for yourself, which means you get the future updates, of course, and I believe that will set you back $15. However, if that sounds too steep for you, you're not quite sure if you want it, there is a demo that you can try, a trial, if you will, and you can play that for free, just to make sure it works on your computer, all that good stuff, before you spend any money on it whatsoever. So that is admirable. I like the fact that you can try it out for yourself, so people don't get confused with what they're buying. But of course, I'm going to show you the game as it stands right now, with its most recent update. And it's been since November since I last showed you what Wildfire Worlds actually look like. And yes, this is in-game. This is what the visuals aesthetic is. The graphic style is all papercraft. That is what it's made to look like. So if we zoom in on these little civilians down here, you can see them going to different shops. We can see traffic, stopping at lights, people crossing at the crosswalk, the whole nine yards. There will be some civil unrest as some people try to spray paint the walls, like this young man over here, and there will be a police officer probably to arrest him as this civilian is calling it in. So that's pretty much how it works for now. You can see them all swarming him. They're going to beat him up, put him in the back of the car, and take him to jail. But we're going to go one step above spray painting. We're going to try to start a riot, but what's worth noting on the menu here, if I go to the level select, this is what has been added most recently. We do have this same map, but I think it's in three different forms. I haven't tried Petri Dish yet, so I can't be 100% certain. However, the default game of which we're playing here is London City Disorder. And our point is to take our Agents of Destruction and start mayhem in the city. That's the basic goal. Some alpha testers have said this is too hard. In my brief playtest here, I probably would agree with him out of what I've played. So that's why there's London in the balance, which does make it a little bit easier for playtesters. So if I get real stumped here in London City Disorder, we'll try out the easier game mode. But going in back into the game, what do we do? Well, first of all, we have to summon our Agent of Destruction. And we want to place him next to a group of civilians that are also away from police officers. Police officers will thwart our tasks very frequently. They are quite a nuisance. And our goal here is to convert other people to our cause. So I want to find the big group of them away from the police officers. Here's a cop over here, so we want to stay away from him. I like to try to pick my first position very carefully. I don't know if this is the best place, but it seems like I'm guaranteed to pick up at least one other person, so I'll place it down. I'm going to immediately start converting this guy, and we can actually control where these guys go by left-clicking and holding left-click, but I'm going to try to let him catch some people on his own, but they're too quick for him, which is one of the primary problems I've noticed, is that it's really difficult to catch people. But then again, if it was super easy to catch people, it wouldn't be much of a game now, would it? Now, if I let them go to their own devices, they will try to destroy the city, which will cause some others to come out of it, which is interesting. And you can see I'm already converting. Uh-oh, I just lost two of my guys because I was not paying attention and I was talking instead. And now I've got the police on my trail. So when the police are on your trail, they're like really annoying hound dogs. They just don't leave you alone. And in fact, here they come. Okay, guys, just come over here. Follow me. Try to lose them on the fence line. Maybe they'll go away. Maybe we'll run a little bit faster than them. Maybe they'll just lose interest completely. Now, it's important that you be careful when crossing the street. That seems silly, but regular civilians can cross the street just fine and not worry about getting hurt. However, with our little rioters here, they can actually be squashed by vehicles and cars. Oh my goodness, okay, this is why they have said that it's too difficult. Look how many coppers are chasing me right now. There's like six. There's so many. All right, we can get this guy. This guy wants to be part of us. No, he just wants to run inside and hide. That's fine. Let's try to convert this person. I'm not really sure how the conversion works. Maybe I need to let go of my left mouse button to let them to their own devices so that they can try to convert someone for me. But just holding it down, you'll see that the area of effect that I'm is growing on the screen, because we're eventually, hopefully, going to have more than just two people to work with here. And that was unfortunate because I've lost everyone now because there's six policemen chasing me and they don't stop. They are hounds. Okay, so I tried playing the other game type where it's a little bit easier. These guys get some kind of signs that makes them like superpower. Look how fast they're going now. I mean, goodness sakes, we're just booking it now. And what happens when you get to this point is you can just start swarming people. Look, we've just even converted a police officer. We're going like Katamari Damacy. Don't run me! No! The car's like going off the road. Okay, it's fine though. We've crashed the car. We're just gonna swarm everybody now. We're just going as fast as we can. Okay, Look, we've even got some more people spreading across the street that we're not controlling. So the idea is the more people that you get, eventually some people are going to be outside of your control. You're going to be able to rampage and just destroy these buildings. Like, if I just hold it, you can see the building crack there and all the people start coming out. And we start converting massive amounts of people simultaneously. So the idea is, you see all these lights on in this building here? If we just get all of these people against the building, people will start jumping out. And then we can start attacking them. But we gotta watch out for all the cars and stuff. I'm not sure how, like, the vehicles work when you start getting a larger group. I do want to be careful. Now, what's interesting is that the townspeople will start trying to repair the buildings that you are, you know, destroying. There's gonna be some engineers and other things like that that are kind of gonna get in your way, basically. So let's see what happens when I just let these people go. I don't want to let too many of them get off screen or get run over, but we are converting quite a number of them just by running around. So, finally, yes, I would say that there needs to be some kind of balance, I think, between the game mode that I was playing before and the easy mode that I'm playing now. I would like to see some other way to control these guys besides holding left mouse button and dragging around, because if you want to select some of them, I feel like if you can control them like this, then when you let go, I don't think that they should just go and just scatter wherever they want to go. If that makes sense, almost like it should be more of like a real-time strategy element where you can actually tell them to go and patrol somewhere. You could tell them to attack move, maybe, or you could tell them, you know, they should try to avoid cops a little bit more. Even when there's only one of you, when there's only one agent of destruction, they will attempt to attack a police officer. They just can't do it. So I'd like to see a little bit of improvement on the AI as far as that concerned. You can see they're building one of these. Oh, they just reconstructed that building before my eyes. So let's just run over here and be like, you know what, sirs? You think you've got this building. Actually, let's take this police officer first. Let's get the police officer down. We've got the building destroyed. Let's see if we can take out a car. We're going to try to take out this car. Bad idea. Such a bad idea. We're just going to go this way and try to find some more people to add to our group. I don't want to lose this entire group right now. Oh, there's a huge slew of people around this thing. I'm just gonna let these guys go. This should actually, they should start converting a lot more people like this. I just kinda wanna corral them into the same group. The other thing about the controls are, if you hold down left mouse button, the circle grows. So I wish that maybe right mouse button would make the circle grow and left mouse button would just highlight, because maybe I don't wanna control every single green guy at once, you know? So you're not gonna have a choice whenever the circle continues to grow as big as it can get. So that could be problematic in the future. Alright, let's try to find some more people. I want to kind of stay away from the subways because I think it's possible for people to run into the subways. Oh! Was that a grenade? Did they just throw grenades? Let's try to get this building to explode. We're just going to let our people scatter a little bit to try to start converting people. I think the signs make them a little bit more powerful. Why are they just exploding and popping like that? Oh my goodness. I think we've caused a greater level of destruction here. I'm just going to kind of let it go and see what happens from this point on. I think that they've separated enough that they're gonna just cause mayhem. I don't know if there's enough people doing conversions. There's a lot of them getting run down in the streets. Some of them are trying to take down these buildings. There's blood pretty much everywhere. More and more buildings are going down, but I don't know if I have a force big enough that the police can't deal with it yet. And they do keep, they're shooting now. They have guns. You guys need to do something about this cop. He just threw one grenade. He just blew up some police officer. What's even happening right now? He's throwing another grenade. I don't think I have a big enough force yet to deal with this city by itself, but you can see how this is, you know, advancing very, very quickly. As soon as things start getting a little bit out of control, they really get out of control. But I do think I have lost most of my force for now just because I have deselected most of them. So I'm just gonna like try to like left mouse button all around here, try to get most of them back and try to get them to corral into this yard and get some of these people. Grab some of these people, man. We need some conversions. We need to bring some more people to the cause. Once they start getting grenades and guns, the policemen just get really insanely difficult to deal with. I don't even know what you're supposed to do. They just almost one-shot you. But yeah, this is an interesting game. Definitely going to be keeping my eye on it. You can already see that the chaos is forming, much as it was promised in previous videos. Probably more so than you ever anticipated, judging by the cutesy papercraftness. I mean, look how reckless this guy is, especially this one in particular. He's just capping dudes. He's throwing grenades into crowds. Maybe they should consider using, like, tear gas or something before they just result to blowing everyone up. I don't know, just my two cents. I would also like to see if cars can run over the agents of destruction. They should also run over policemen or other civilians, in my opinion, because it seems a little bit one-sided as far as the traffic is concerned. But anyways, guys, I just wanted to give you a brief preview of where this game has come, and I wasn't expecting it to be this crazy, to be perfectly honest with you. But hopefully you got a good taste of it. So if you want to try the game out for yourself, again, there is a trial on the website, linked in the description of this video. If you enjoyed this video and you would like to see more indie games spotlighted in the future like this, please let me know by leaving me a like and a comment on this video. And of course, if you haven't already, consider subscribing. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.